Bwana Yesu asifiwe, child of God. It is another great honor to have you in this session. And it is my desire, just as John says in the book of 3 John verse 2, that you are indeed prospering in all things and even in health, just as your soul prospereth. So in this season and period, we have been looking at a very delicate and important, a fundamental in the Christian walk. That is the topic about the Holy Spirit. So we have been taken through sessions, and just to remind you, we have looked at who is the Holy Spirit. We have looked at why do you need him, a very important topic. We have also looked at how can you get him. My friend, if this may have passed you for one reason or another, kindly just go retrieve it from our repository in Facebook and even in YouTube. You can get the videos there so that you can have a good flow of the topic. Because today now we want to delve into another important part, fundamental part of this series of the Holy Spirit. We want to look at how one can walk in the Spirit. It is one thing to know the Spirit. It is one thing to know how to get him. It is another different thing totally to know how you can keep in step and walk with him. That is where the miracle is. That is where the gist of the matter is. So join me, Samuel Ajo Victor, in this season of Life Series for this particular topic. Stay tuned. One amazing thing that Christ Jesus told his disciples was this: do not leave Jerusalem until the promise, the one who was promised, comes. So that interests me, because to me, at that particular time, Christ was the cornerstone. He is still the cornerstone, but in this particular context, in that time, he was the cornerstone. He was the all in all. But it was so important for him to tell the Spirit, his disciples, to wait for this particular person. And he even tells them not even to go on evangelism, but to wait until the promised Holy Spirit is sent. So I ask myself, why is the Holy Spirit so important? Why is it that Christ Jesus is so much interested in you and me, just like the disciples back then, receiving the Holy Spirit? And then I remember something from the book of Romans chapter 8 verse 29, and this is what the Bible says. Romans 8 verse 29, it says this: for whom he foreknew, this is the blueprint, if I can call it, of God. For whom he foreknew, he there is God. For whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren. So my friend, I want you to look at this intricately. God had a plan that all of us should conform to the image of Christ Jesus. So there is already an established destination for you and me. There is what God expects at the end from you and me. And that is that we should look like, we should be conformed to the image of Christ Jesus. Now that brings me to a very interesting topic. The question is now, how do I end up being conformed to the image of Christ Jesus? And I thank God, because we have an answer. And the answer is one. The answer is the Holy Spirit. In the book of Galatians chapter 5, Paul is addressing this church, this amazing church. And this, despite the many shortcomings that probably they exhumed in chapter 3, in chapter 5 now, Paul is admonishing them and showing them the way of how to be better. And if we can a little bit just look at the Galatian church, because in one way or another, probably you and me have found ourselves in the position they were in. Look at the book of Galatians, and particularly look at verse 1. Verse 1 says, stand fast therefore in the liberty by which Christ has made us free, and do not be entangled again with a yoke of bondage. So the Galatians had a behavior or a custom of being entangled again. Just like me sometimes, and probably you, my listener, sometimes you find yourself in the wrong way of things, in the wrong way of the scriptures probably. And so Paul here is trying to address that, and he's telling them that the one of the ways, or the only way you can overcome that shortcoming, is what he says in verse 25 of the same chapter. So verse 25, he says this: if we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. In verse 16, if I may take you back a bit, I say then, walk in the Spirit and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Now, here is the two-point lesson of my talk to this day today. One, the Holy Spirit is the person that helps you to accomplish the destination, and that is the conformation to the image of Christ Jesus. Then number two, the things that probably may hinder you and me from attaining that conformation, and that is the bondage or the lust or the pleasures of the world. How to overcome them? It is so simple to tell someone, stop. But it is not that easy. We both know that. Now, there is a better way. There is a much more easier way, and that is by keeping in step with the Holy Spirit. That is by walking with the Spirit. The Holy Spirit speaks. He will speak to you. He will speak through men of God. He will speak through the Word of God. He will speak even in your own heart, because you are a son of God. So once you keep in step, once you walk with the Spirit, you can be able to conform to the image of God. And then number two, all this present lust and even the present bondage, you can be able to walk away with them. Child of God, it is my desire and my prayer that both me and you shall be conformed to this image of Christ Jesus, and that we shall be able to overcome the lust and even the pleasures of this age by the power of the Spirit. But kindly join me as I join you in walking with the Spirit. Thank you so much. And see you once again in our next episode of Life Series. God bless you. God love you. We love you also. Thank you so much.